Hi viewers, welcome to LMS Solution. Today we are going to see about MATLAB simulation of fuzzy tuned PA controller based V bar of controller induction motor. Thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming video. So first you have to see about basic of that V bar of controller induction motor based upon fuzzy tuned PA controller. Now consider induction motor. So that induction motor is going to be connected with the induction motor is going to be drive by means of voltage source inverter. So the voltage source inverter powered by DC supply. And then here we are going to measure the speed of the induction motor, and it's going to be compared with the reference speed. Okay, so here we have to compare that actual with the reference speed. So this is actual speed of the induction motor, and then so the after comparison, right? So it going to be processed by a fuzzy tuned PA controller. So input for this fuzzy tuned PA controller will be this error. So output of this PA controller is frequency of operation of induction motor. Okay, so after that this frequency will be converted into control signal, three control signal, because we need a three sinusoidal waveform to generate the pulse, right? So the three sinusoidal waveform need to be compared with the triangular wave in order to generate the pulse for that voltage source inverter. So based upon this frequency, okay, you have to convert, that mean you have to generate control signal. So it will generate three control signal with the varying voltage and varying frequency form, right? So that be V bar of form, right? So this control signal have varying voltage and varying frequency. So based upon this frequency, and then it going to be processed via pulse generator, that means PWM pulse generator. And then after pulse generation, it going to be drive the switches in the voltage system motor to control the speed of the induction motor. So this is the working of that positive PA controller based V bar of control of induction motor. So just you have to measure the actual speed, and it going to be compared with the reference speed. So this going to be processed via positive PA controller. So output going to be mapped as frequency. So based upon this frequency, you have to generate the control signal, three control signal. So that means three sinusoidal waveform with the varying voltage and varying frequency. Okay, so that going to be compared with the triangular wave here, right? To generate the pulse width modulation signal. So that PWM pulse going to be control the voltage source inverter of that. That means switch, power switch in the voltage source inverter, and it going to be drive the induction motor. Okay, so this is the actual concept of this fuzzy tuned PA controller based V bar of controller induction motor. So next you have to see the implementation of that fuzzy tuned PA controller based V bar of controller induction motor. So here you can see that, so this one is the voltage source inverter. So this voltage source inverter connected with the DC source. So this voltage source inverter output is connected to the induction motor to drive the motor. And this induction motor receive the load torque by means of this block, right? So we can give constant torque, otherwise we can provide varying torque input for that induction motor, that means mechanical load, right? And then here we are going to measure two input. So one is rotor speed, another one is electromagnetic torque. So this rotor speed will be seen radian per second. So that should be converted into RPM by means of this conversion block 30 divided by pi. So the speed will be in RPM. So after that, this actual speed in RPM, right? So when we compare with the reference speed, so it will be generate error, right? So this error signals process via fuzzy tuned PA controller. The fuzzy tuned PA controller will generate the frequency operation of that induction motor. Okay, so we go inside that block, right? So it receive error input, right? This fuzzy tuned PA controller will receive error input. So here the fuzzy online gain tuner, fuzzy tuner will receive two inputs. So one is error, so another one is change of error. Okay, this output of this fuzzy tuned gain tuner, so output will be one is KP, another one is KA. Okay, so this KP and KA going to be multiplied in the, so KA going to be multiplied in the here, right? It may be multiplied with the error and process via integrator. The gain KP is multiplied in the error. Okay, and finally the output of integration and output of this proportional part will be added here, and then finally it will be generate the controlled frequency or frequency of operating frequency of that induction motor. Okay, after that the frequency is going to be converted into three sinusoidal waveform, control signal form, so for generating the pulse. Okay, so that three control signal will be act as a reference signal for that PWM pulse generation. Okay, so here you can see that based upon that frequency is going to be converted into FT, right? So by means of this integration and addition, okay, so it will generate a three kind of waveform, right, with the phase shift of 120 degree. And then from that that mean by using that FT, so you have to calculate the sine of 2 pi FT, right? And then and also you have to generate the amplitude, so based upon the frequency, right? So here we will get three sinusoidal waveform with the varying voltage and frequency form, right? So this three control signal, ABC control signal, right, when we compared with the triangular wave, okay, so this is a control signal from that previous block, right? It is going to be compared with the triangular wave, and then it is going to generate the pulse for that switch in the voltage source inverter, right? So this pulse going to be connected to this MOSFET switch in the voltage source inverter to control the speed of the induction motor. Okay, so here we are created some scenario, right? So I will show you that one. See, here you can see that the step time will be kept as 5, that means up to 5 second the speed, reference speed is at 1500 RPM. After 5 second the reference speed will be changed to 1000 RPM. Okay, same way you can see, here you can see that the load torque, right, load torque also here we are having varying load torque, right, from 0 to 3 seconds, right, from 0 to 3 second the load torque will be 5 newton meter, and then from 6 to 7, right, after 3 second the torque will be changed from 5 to 10 newton meter, after 6 to 7 second side the torque will be maintained at 10 newton meter, After 7, then load torque change from 10 Newton meter to 20 Newton meter. After 8 to 10, the Newton meter, that means load torque will be maintained at 20 Newton meter. Okay. So here we have created a change in varying load condition also, right? So next you have to see the outputs of the simulation. So here first one is this frequency of, that means output from the positive and PA controller, right? So for initially that load torque will be 5 Newton meter from 0 to 3, right? From 0 to 3 the torque will be 5 Newton meter. After that torque will be going to change to 5 Newton meter to 10 Newton meter, right? Here you can see that is maintained at 10 Newton meter. So here you can see that it will be 5 Newton meter, right? After 8 second, right? After 7 second, then load are going to change from 10 Newton meter to 20 Newton meter. Okay, so here the control signal from that positive PA controller. So initially the frequency will be start increasing in order to get the rotate the induction motor at the reference speed, right? Reference speed setting. So reference speed setting is 1500 rpm, right? So for 1500 rpm it generate the frequency around nearly 50 hertz, right? So because of that 50 hertz, you can see that the speed of the induction motor maintain at the 1500 rpm. So this frequency will be connected into the 3 control signal, right? So this is the output of that control signal, right? Generation of that control signal for to generate the pulse. Okay. So this sinusoidal, these 3 sinusoidal going to be compared with the triangular wave to generate the pulse for that MOSFET of the voltage source inverter. Okay. So here you can see that. So this is output of that inverter, that means voltage of that inverter, and then this is inverter current, otherwise we can call it as applied voltage of the induction motor and then current through that source current of the inductor, that means current flowing through that induction motor. Okay, so already told, right? Up to 5 seconds, the reference speed maintained, that means fixed at 1500 rpm. So you can see that the induction motor reaches to that reference speed, okay, 1500 rpm. After 5 seconds, right, the reference speed changed to 1500 to 1000 rpm, right? Now you can see that because of that change in reference speed, so the speed will be changes to 1500 to 1000 here, right? Now you can see that after 7 seconds, okay, the load torque change from 10 Newton meter to 20 Newton meter, right? So because of that you can see the changes in the electromagnetic torque of the induction motor. So even the increasing load torque, right? So you can see that the speed is maintained at the the induction motor is track the reference speed command, right? So by means of that positive PA controller. So because of change in reference speed, right? So you can see the change in the frequency operation of induction motor, that means control signal from that positive PA controller here, right? The frequency operation changed from nearly 50 hertz to around 35 hertz, right? So because of changing frequency, so you will get the speed changes in the induction motor. Okay, so this is the operation of positive PA controller based V bar of control of induction motor. So thanks for watching our videos. kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for a notification about upcoming videos. Thank you so much.